Video, let us understand how to resize plots in R. And for this, we will be using a library called REPR, which is used for serializable representations. And these are nothing but string and binary representations. Okay, and we'll see how it works. Actually, this is all theory, and let's just believe in doing practice. So just using the library REPR as I mentioned, REPR, and after that what I'll do is I'll be working with Iris data, and this is being preloaded, and I made a video previously how to preload a data and how to see various data sets, right? You can just write here data and you can see various data which are being in R. You can simply see all these things, and here you will find all the data sets, right? Air passenger, CO2, BOD, and many more data sets are here. Cars data set and stuff. Okay, so now this was an additional information not needed. So what I do is, now since we are going to change the size of our plot, so for that I would have to import a library to plot our data, and we'll be using ggplot2. So let us see ggplot2. So this ggplot2 is a very useful library in R, which just helps you in plotting so many data, and I have dealt in ggplot2 in depth in the course R, which I'll be explaining you in detail the various layers and everything which is being taken care of. So let us just understand our data. This iris data is, again, you know, iris is a flower, I would say the species of a flower, wherein we have to classify three species of iris: setosa, versicola, and virginica. So this is the head, these are equally distributed. The details of these of this iris data set analysis has been done in a different tutorial altogether. Let's just focus on our plotting. So here we have ggplot, and then this is iris, since this is the data, and then I'm working with aesthetics. So this aesthetics is the second layer. Okay, I'll be explaining you this thing just shortly. And then what I'll write here is, suppose I'll write here sepal dot width, and y I will mention, because you have to mention your x and y, that is what aesthetics mean. And here I will write here sepal dot width, sepal length, let's take here sepal length. Okay, my spelling is right, and I will give it the type, what type I want. So I will give here genome, and point is used actually for scatter, so that's what I want to see, the relationship between the two. So this is what I'm going to do. So this is, can you see the size of this plot? Actually, nothing happened when we just imported this library. We have to use a few commands to understand this thing. Okay, so this is the actual size that you will get by default in your Jupyter notebook while working. And this really becomes, you know, really difficult to understand the plot, and you'll have to keep on scrolling, you know, finding the x-axis and the y-axis. So what I do is, I would simply set this axis now, okay? And what I will do is, let's just, I'll just comment this, because it's a good practice that you just change the size of the plot. And I will just change the size. How would I do it? I will just write here options, and I will use the library REPR dot, okay, plot dot. So set the size and width and length, height of your plot, and let this be standard, like, okay, let it be 6. And then again I will use here REPR dot plot dot height, and this would be equals to 3. Alright, so this is how I set this. And now what I do is, I would simply copy paste this, control C, and then I'll show you what it looks. So now can you see, much more manageable in simple glance. You can see the entire plot of sepal length and sepal width. So this is what you have to mention to change the size of the plot. Also, these are just two layers which we are working with. And we can add another thing to make our plot really look nice, and that is, we can use color here to represent the species. Okay, so what I can do is, before that I want to show you something. And that is like we are just working on just two layers, that is data and aesthetics. There are seven layers in ggplot2, which I was referring to. And each of these layers are being dealt in the course of Udemy, which is of course designed for absolute beginners in R. And actually this would take you to a very comfortable position wherein you can really understand the layers, use it in your plot and make it really appealing. So what I do is I can simply show you the difference and how can you really add more value to your, you know, each and every visualization that you're presenting should add more meaning to it, right? So I'm just adding species so that it becomes more clear. So all these things are dealt in a very systematic manner with explanation in the course. And the advantage of taking a course is that you get everything in line, in systematic manner, structured way. Whereas in YouTube, you find many videos in the playlist, but it won't find a connect, you know, a logical connection with one lecture to the another lecture. So here it's more of a reference material, but that is like served as a pathway, you know. So here you can see that I have my axis, the aesthetics mentioned, X and Y, and I see the relation between sepal length and sepal width, and also, you know, the species, like this is setosa, this is versicolor, and blue is virginica. I can add more and more things to this. I can add, you know, several layers, as I told you. I can add themes, I can add facets, statistics, geometry, coordinates, and this is dealt extensively in the course, guys. I have prepared it very with a lot of patience and a lot of research, specially designed for beginners. So go through that course, the module one, so that you understand things better. And this is something very basic, you know, resizing your plot. So we do it by this. So I'll just zoom in so that you understand what this actually is. This is the command that I have mentioned. So you don't have to, you know, replay this video again and again. You can just take a snapshot of it and yeah, you can copy paste it as and when you require. Change the width and height and you will see the resultant plot here. Okay. So this is it for this video, and I would be coming up with more tutorials on Iris and empty cars. I'm getting a request of empty cars, so I'll be coming with the empty cars visualization and analysis. And thank you for watching.